Hello all. So in this class, we'll discuss about how to edit a line and a polygon. In the last class, I told you how to create it. So while creation, it's not always that we get the best, best editing. So how to go about editing? So I open the QGIS software. So I'll create a layer. So generally, when you're doing the editing or digitizing, the first time when you create it, you digitize from an existing topo sheet or a satellite image. So I'm not using all that as a background. Generally, you have to have a georeferenced image or a projected image on which you are doing your digitization. Since I'm only focusing on how to digitize and how to edit the digitized line or polygon, I'm just having a plain background so that you can understand it better. So create layer, new spatial layer. So first I'll create, a random ABCD line. If you want any specific location, you can, give a specific location. That's up to you. So I'm okay with this. I'm not giving any, I'm not going into attributes. I'm just dealing with the geometry. So I'm just happy with the basic ID number. And then, okay. And I'm projection also. See, all this projection, you have to do it correctly if you're doing a project. Since I'm only dealing with editing a line, I'm not going into all these details, okay? So I'm just, if you want, in your project, you will be having attributes. Here, I'm just keeping it simple. Just your ID. Okay. Okay. So I have created a line. So I'll just draw a random line also. So if you open the attribute table, you don't have anything except one column, which has to be filled. So I'll go to this edit mode here, toggle editing. Then here, I'm making a line. So as I click, a line is being formed. Now, if I want to undo it, I have to click on delete or backspace. So delete or backspace, I can go back. Okay. So I'm digitizing it again, either delete or backspace, it'll go to your previous point. And once it is over, I have to give a right click. I have to give the ID. If I've given other attributes, I have to give the other attributes also. Then click OK. Then my line is formed. If I want to change the color of the line, if I want to something darker, generally when you have a topo sheet, it's confusing today. So you can have a darker tinge line also. You can experiment with other colors. Okay. So you have a lot of choices in that. If you want red, you can have red too. Okay. So this is how you change the style. So I'll save the edit and remove. Now this line is being created. Now in the existing line, I want to make changes in the line. So I'll again go to edit mode. And there's an option called as vertex tool. So I'll click on the vertex tool. So you can see already it is highlighted. Okay. Now if I want to remove a vertex, I have to click on the vertex and delete. Just single click and delete. If I want to move the vertex, I have to double click and then move. Okay. So I repeat again. If I want to delete this vertex, if I feel this is not going in alignment, I have to just give a single click and delete. If I want to move my vertex, I have to double click and then move. If I want to add any vertex again and on the line, double click and move. Move. If I want to add here, double click here and move. And move. Okay. So generally what happened by default, anywhere in the line, the vertex in the middle is moved. So it's always better. And then move. Okay. And then move. So these are some of your basic editing tool for your line. So I have told you how to, remove, undo by delete or backspace. To create, to delete a vertex, single click, click on delete on the keyboard. If you want to move, I have to double click and move through my mouse. Okay. And if I want to add a new one, generally across a plus sign will come. I have to double click there and move my vertex. So this is for your line. So these are some basic editing work for your line. Next, I'll come to polygon. So I'll create a polygon layer. Create again shape file polygon. So I'll name it as X, Y, and Z. Polygon. I'm not giving other details. I'm okay. So I'll just, to avoid confusion, I'm just removing this. If you want some other color again, you can go to styles, change your color. That is your choice. So here again, I'm going to edit mode. So since it's selected, it'll automatically show polygon. So polygon. So polygon, generally what happens, your polygon here is a connected polygon. As you're moving the points, it'll expand in its area. So if I'm digitizing, I'll start digitizing like this. Okay. Be careful. If you come like this, it'll happen like this. Okay, so don't cross it, but sometimes you'll be forced to cross. I'll just give you one more example. Undo. Okay, this is again to remove a vertex. I have to go to delete or backspace. Now, as I am digitizing it, see when I'm digitizing, I'll be digitizing very finely. So as I'm digitizing, remember, I'll go back again. See here. If you notice, my point is here. So if my point, it is coming like this. But my next point is here, it will take it. So while you digitize it, sometimes you have an overlap. But as I move my cursor, the overlap will go. Okay? So don't bother. See, if I'm here and then here, your overlap will go. So don't bother about it. Okay? So again here, delete or backspace, I can undo. Okay. And once my digitization is over, I right click, null, ID I've given 1. So this is my polygon. Now here again, if I want to remove, change any vertex, vertex tool. So vertex is already highlighted. The same thing as your line, click once to remove your this. Click twice to move my vertex. If I want to add a new vertex, in that plus sign only you're allowed, you can move it. Okay, you can move it. Okay, so again I repeat, single click to delete, double click the vertex to move. And if you want to add anything, you have to come to the plus sign, double click and add your vertex. So this is your, and again you can play with the colors inside. If you want, you can have an outline also. So this is some of the basic editing for your line and your polygon. Remember, I need to have a base map, a topo sheet or a satellite image on which I'm digitizing. I'm not having that now because I'm only focused on telling you how to do the editing work. Okay, so thank you. And before I close again, see now these layers are stored in a folder. Now it is not necessary to save your project. Your saving is required when I'm going, if I'm doing some work now, maybe after 2 hours, I'm continuing the work. Then, okay, I can save the project. Okay, I'm saving the project in the folder. Where is this? QGIS. Yeah, QGIS. So it saves as the entire project. Now, when I save it as a project, I'm saving it as Preeti. Save it as a project. When I take back the project, when I open the project again, if I've changed the location of XZ and ABC, it will ask for the location again. Otherwise, it won't open. Okay, I repeat again, I have saved the project. So if it has to open like this again, if suppose the file, the storage of file of XYZ and ABC has changed, it won't open here. It will first ask you for where's the location. But if you don't know the location, it won't open. So generally, I recommend saving a QGIS project only when you're planning to do it immediately, maybe within 1-2 days. If you're planning to open again after 1-2 weeks, I generally don't suggest to close a project because it is not useful. But if you're doing a project wherein you are near, you know, more than 50%, then again it is useful because you will be having lot of layers. So in that time, it is useful to save the project. But again, you should be very clear, if you have changed your location of these layers, you have to retrace it back. They'll be asking you what is the location of your new layers. You have to give the location. If you have not changed, it is well and good. See, the changes will come when you are stored. See, you may have stored this project in a pen drive and given it to someone else. So when they open it there, what will happen? All these layers are missing. So they'll ask you the location of the layers. So if you have not given the layers there, you can't open it. Okay. But if you're having another file where these layers are there, they'll ask you the location, give the location. It will open again completely. So thank you for the class. In this class, I've just dealt with basic editing of your line and your polygon.